see and I know. Oh, that's why me not gonna let go. Oh no, I know that Jah Jah live forever.
The introduction of the Emperor in English.
His Majesty Negus Haile Selassie, I call upon the first delegate of Ethiopia. The speech which you are about to hear will be given in the Amharic language.
In the shadows of the press gallery, Italian newspaper men are ready for an outbreak against the emperor whose country their country has taken, waiting for his first words.
Monsieur le Président. Monsieur le...
Trying to quell the disturbance, lights turned out. Again, lights out. The disturber's ejected, arrested, and he is able to make his appeal.
Haile Selassie continued, and he said this: it is international morality that is at stake. Apart from the kingdom of the Lord, there is not on this earth any nation which is superior to any other. It is us today, it will be you tomorrow.
Continuing, we have the trumpets, the blowing of the trumpets, Rastafari. There's the election, the elect of the Rastafari, and the redeemed Beta Ethiopian Hebrew Israelite nation, tribe nation. Now, the connection right here in Revelation chapter 7 is amazing. The Garmenia, right? When we look at this right here, we have that there are four angels. Remember, there are four blood moons, right? Could be the first trumpet, but Haile Selassie said, right, it might as well be the last. So there's a judgment coming for, right? But there's also a warning of repentance. This is where we have the 10 days of awe. So we have Yom Teruah, right, which is the shofar or the blowing of the trumpets, right? Actually, it's a silver trumpet, according to scripture, but the shofar is also a key and a significance. Now, how does this really connect with the redeemed or the remnant that's out of Israel? Well, when we begin off in the saved, those who are saved, right, in the true teaching of His Majesty and the testimony of His Christ. Right? It's the teaching of His Majesty and the testimony of His Christ. And now the link with that blowing of the trumpet. So we ask the question, Rastafari, is it the last trumpet? Right? Is this the last trumpet? Right? Could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Now we have to connect this with the Hebrew, right? With the Hebrew or the HaMoshiach, the Messianic or the Moshiach mind. Right, the mind of the Messiah, right, and He reveals to us in His Word and through the Ruach HaKodesh His mind, right. So many have interpreted these words based on their own imaginations. What we're going to seek to do is to look at these signs in this Moedim, but we clearly see that the connection is with the Moedim of Yahweh Elohim, the appointed times. Right, the appointed times. They are not so-called Jewish feasts. They are Yahweh's feasts. Right? They say Jews are the people of God. Well, then the line of the tribe of Judah is God. When you recognize what the scripture is saying, right? When the rich men, the kings of the earth, the great men, the chief captains, the mighty men, the bondmen, the free men hide themselves in the dens and the rocks of the mountains, and they say to the mountains and rocks to fall on us and to hide us from the face of Him that sits upon the throne, and here's the key, from the wrath of the Lamb, from the Father, the King of Kings, and from the Lord of Lords, Yeshua HaMashiach, for the great day, right, the great day, which is the Yom HaAdonai, right, the great day of His wrath is come, and the question is, who shall be able to stand? Right? That's the question that ends off chapter 6 of Revelation. When we begin chapter 7, it says, and after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, and that the wind should not blow upon the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw another angel, so Johannes or John the Revelator, the grace of Yah, which is the revealer, right, says that he saw another angel ascending. Not descending, but ascending from the east. Water Misrak Kemelketu, right, where it says turn to the east, look to the east, right, turn to the east. So another angel was ascending from the east, having the seal of the living Elohim, right? And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea. So these four angels, right? There's four blood moons. There's four angels. It is given to these four angels, right, to hurt the earth and the sea. Now this angel that's ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God, this angel says, right, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed, right? So this angel that's coming out of the east is doing a work with others and says we, right? So there's something going on in the east, right? To do what? To seal the servants. Here's the key. The servants of Eloheinu, of our God, our source, in their foreheads. And as I mentioned before, this is the link with the cross and the finding, right? The finding of the true cross, right? The finding of the true cross. Let's just bring this up right here, right? The finding of the true cross. So here we have this right here, that finding of the true cross. Until the servants are sealed, right? Are sealed. Right? If you look at Ezekiel chapter 9, right, which is also connected to this, you'll see where there was a mark. Right, there's a mark. In fact, let's touch on that right here, because we already know after they're sealed, the remnant out of Israel, right, is sealed. And it says, and I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes, of all the tribes of the children of Israel. And the first tribe that is mentioned is out of the tribe of Yehuda, right? Out of the tribe of Judah. Now, Judah was not the firstborn, he was the fourthborn, but Judah comes to the ascendancy, right? And the Judah sign, right, connects with the Lion of the tribe of Judah, right? So we have the Lion of the tribe of Judah. So the first tribe is out of the tribe of Judah, was sealed 12,000, right? And it goes through the 12 tribes of Judah. But interestingly enough, it seems as though one tribe, right? There's one tribe that's not mentioned, we notice, and that seems to be the tribe of Dan, right? And the so-called half tribes, who were half Egyptian, we can say, and they were half Israel from Joseph. They are also mentioned here, namely Ephraim, right? Namely Ephraim, right? Do we have Ephraim here? We see there's Manasseh here, right? The tribe of Gad, tribe of Naphtalim. We have Manasseh, we have Simeon, we have Levi, Issachar. No, we have Joseph, right? So Joseph is there, but we have the tribe of Manasseh. This is interesting. This is really interesting. So we don't have the tribe of Ephraim. We don't see the tribe of Ephraim here. And we don't see the tribe missing is the tribe of Dan, right? So Dan or Dan, and Dan also means judgment. Now there's a vision of the Gentiles who are to be saved, also to be saved during the Great Tribulation, right? During the Great Tribulation. And this is very, very important here, right? So when we say Rastafari, is it the last trumpet before the last judgment, right? And we can see the connection right here, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, right? He who sits on that throne, the throne of David, and the wrath of the Lamb, right? The wrath of Yeshua HaMoshiach, the Lamb, the Se HaElohim, Ye'egziyavi Herbeg, right? And we can see this controversy, right, between the faithful, right, redeemed Beta Ethiopian Hebrew Israelites, and the apostates, right, those who were in the apostasy or the rebellion to the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, removing this off of the flag and bringing in that judgment and bringing forward the wrath of the Lamb. But there's the finding of the true cross, right? This is interesting. The 27th of September, which links with the feast, not the feast, but the fast of Gedaliah, right? We don't have time to go into Gedaliah, but you have to link Gedaliah. Gedaliah was that one during the time when the Babylonians had taken all the people of skill and left behind the poor people. Gedaliah was appointed by the Babylonians to be the governor on the remnant that was left behind. Now, Ishmael, one named Ishmael and his people, and you see the Ishmael type, this is the Mohammedan. You know, we can see that Mohammedan within the matrix and the code of scripture kills Gedaliah, right? The Babylonian appointed governor, right? As well as many of the Yehudi or many of the Jews. Is this a link possibly to certain events concerning the slaying, right? Where ye Ethiopians also shall be slain of my sword. You see the personalness of it there because of the throne of David, right? And the gates of Sion, the gates of Zion. Now, what I wanted to share is regarding the cross, right? You know, the last judgment and the finding of the true cross. Now, in the scriptures, we have this right here. Let's go to Ezekiel chapter 9. And in Ezekiel chapter 9, right, we have here Yahweh is justified in sending his people, the so-called Negroes, black people, into captivity. This is why we say that that was good, right? That was good for us. Slavery was good for us if you recognize truly who we be according to the divine mind. Now, here there's a vision of the slaying in Jerusalem. Right, there's a vision in this chapter of the slaying in Jerusalem, right? And now what's very interesting is just to kind of scroll forward in it, it speaks about those who had a particular mark in verse 4. And it says, and Yahweh, he who be who he be, right, his divine majesty said to him, right, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. So that mark, right, when we look at that mark in the Hebrew, it is the tau, right, or the tewel, the towel. Right, or what ones would say is the sign of the cross, right? So the finding of the true cross, right, which is also part of this appointed time and season. So we have the 24th of September in 2014, the Yom Teruah or the Ras HaSanah HaShana, the Rosh Hashanah, right? So the new year, the blowing of the trumpet. Right. Then we have the 10 days of awe, the 10 days of repentance to Yom Kippur. Right. Then we come to Yom Kippur. Right. Now, what's interesting after Rosh Hashanah. Right. This is interesting. After Rosh Hashanah, it's the third. Right. It's the third day after Rosh Hashanah. Right. On the 27th of September is what we know from our redeemed Beta Ethiopian Hebrew Israelitish tribe nation and among the elect as Rastafari is the finding of the true cross, right? The Lion of the Tribe of Judah, right? The cross carries that cross banner, as you see right here, right? So we have a tight pick on the cross, right? This is why this is that banner of salvation, right? And there is that judgment, right? Those who are in the book of life, right? And those who are in the book of the dead. But even there's that redemption that we see here with this youth, right, being pulled up, right, from among this group, right? So even sparing this child right here is significant. So we can see that mercy, that compassion, that grace, that truth, right? So his judgment is righteous. So when you get into that chapter, Ezekiel chapter 9, you'll find that that mark is the tau, which is the 22nd letter of the Hebrew alphabet that originally was like a cross or an X, right? Where we have the tet, which is like a cross or an X, right? So this is very significant. So these men would have this particular mark on them, but because they are the ones that sigh and that cry, that means they shout for all the abominations that are done among the holy people. You know, someone to come off and say that we might have been too harsh, saying woe to the Ethiopians worshiping fake Mary and Bar Jesus. This is serious, right? Because those are the false images that causes jealousy. Those are the abominations that causes the desolation and even prompts this judgment mode where we're in this present judgment mode. So this is a judgment time, but what we want to speak on, right, is those who are redeemed, right? That redeemed, right? That redeemed, and also the link with that particular remnant, right? That particular remnant. So what we're going to do right here is pause for the cause. We wanted to touch on, you know, we spoke the last trumpet, right? And the finding, right? That finding of the true cross, that the Lion of Judah, right? The Lion of Judah finds the true cross and has found that true cross. So that mark, right? Notice there's even in Revelation, there's different kind of marks. There's the mark of the beast, but there's also the mark or the seal, right? So where are they sealed? In Revelation, the seal is in their foreheads. So we see how the connection with the seal in their foreheads and what the foreheads represent, the forehead is the frontal lobe, right? Ones could call it the third eye if they want, but that's the frontal lobe or in their consciousness. So when we speak about Christ's consciousness, right, or the black Christ, the true Christ in spirit and in truth, Yeshua HaMashiach, in their minds, right, in their minds. And it's interesting when you look at some of the pictures of the Reshaim, right, or the Kufuwoch, the careless Ethiopians, right, the careless Hebrews over here. You see his hand is on his forehead. This one's hand is on their forehead as well, right? Almost like pointing, you can see there's some mark right here, like something's missing. Instead of having that mark of Christ, they have that mark or that mentality of Antichrist, right? So they have not found, right, according to this type, the cross, right? They have not found that cross of Christ. Let me just move this over here, right? So we see right here the lamb, right? That lamb. So the lamb and the lion, right? The lamb and the lion lay together, right? So we have the father and the son, right? He who has the son has the father. Now, when we observe them over here, there's a whole difference. Like they almost like they have their hands in the, you know, the hands over the heart in that cross, like where Jacob, you know, transposition his hands in the blessing, notice, of Ephraim and Manasseh. But we don't find Ephraim, right, within those tribes within, I gotta look over that again, because I thought, sure, that Ephraim was there in the remnant out of Israel, but it's very clear that Ephraim, let me go over it one more time, is not there. Instead, we have Joseph, the tribe of Joseph, and the tribe of Manasseh. Right? And this is all connected with the Great Tribulation. Right? The Lion of Judah and the Great Tribulation. Right? This Great Tribulation period. This sign and the seal. The sign and the seal. So, Wendemoch, Hitoch, Natoch, stay tuned. And once again, right, a Shana Tov, right, a good, right, a good year, right, as we enter into this good year in his grace and in his truth. Shalom Ras Teferi.